Welcome to ITE 351 module number 7. Alright. So lesson title, business models. Then for the lesson objectives, by the end of the module, the student is expected to be able to 1. List and explain different business models. So before you start a business, you should have what we call business plan. So part of that is the business models. So number 2, identify what business model is used for a certain business. So kumbaga muna siyang natawag na architecture, kumbaga kung sa plano pa magpatindog ka sa balay, kung sa system naman project naton mock-up design. So mock-up design is not the actual system, so it's all about mock-up. And then ang aton nga system o sa mga ginatawag naton nga ano nga ginapresent naton sa mga panelist. So for the materials, we have student activity sheet, internet, then for the reference, so you may access this reference, okay, online. So for the productivity tip, imagining on how you can gain income is how business models are invented and reinforced. So at the end of the day, business falls to an income. So dapat maka-generate ka sang income, mga kwarta, kabiskan piso lang na. So potential or possibility pa nang mag-grow. So for the lesson preview review, welcome back future new venture capitalist. Today we will be we will encounter a few of the many business models that exist in the world. We mentioned in the previous module that we will be discussing the business models. Some of this you are already aware of, you just don't know how to explain. Okay, so proceed. Number one, or activity one, so we have here again what I know table. What are business models? Number two, what essential is business model for IT ventures? So meaning sang essential, kumbaga kinanlan bala. So there are so many business models around the world, okay, or that exist, or that is being, or that was being used by the businesses, okay, exist right now. Pero ano ba lang yung tawag nga essential para sa mga IT ventures? So later after this module, you can answer the what I learned. Alright, so let's proceed. Ano ba lang natawag na business model? As we mentioned before, business models are firm's plan or recipe for how it creates. Diba? Kung i-compare pa sa pagluto, so amo na siya ang natawag na recipe. Ano ba lang, magluto ka sa adobo, ano-anong mga kailan mo ang mga recipe. Diba? So same with business, may minatawag kita nga recipe. So ano tawag siya na? It is a business model. Delivers and captures value for its stakeholders. Business models are foundational to a firm ability to succeed both in the short and long term. So we have short and long term business gali, kumbaga panandalian lamang or panghabang buhay. So ano ba lang dapat mo ibrahon? No, ano dapat mo i-build? Okay? It is a short or long term. Especially when it is the first one to introduce a new product or service to customers. So, for the business model and IT industry manages to pave a way for a better income in business models. From the rise of advertisement we see almost anywhere in the internet, an increase of subscription type of access to internet contents economy through IT has never been better. So amo na siya ang aton nga business model and IT. Alright, so hope you see the significant the IT ventures. List of business models. Oh, ano-ano na bilang natawag natin yung business models? Here, we have a list of business models. Most of these are actually applicable to IT. Or better yet, used in the IT industry. So, advertising. From the name itself, again, you can build advertising company with in our field. Oh, di ba? So there are so many advertisement company. Okay, ano brao nyo? All you need to do is to create what we call advertisement. Dapat may prior knowledge ka sa nagit. May ara ka sa ano? May ara ka sa prior knowledge in photographs, video editing, di ba? Lubriko? Oh, nagit. Hindi ko kasunod sa So kung may gusto ka mo yung bal, ano lang di, chat lang. Okay? So proceed kita. So dapat in advertisement, okay, company. Ano ni bala? Okay, so Rita Nay. From the name itself, it gains income from advertisements or ads. Before, ads can be found only on the newspaper. Diba? Newspaper, billboards and television. Now you can see them almost anywhere on the internet. Companies pay advertisers such as YouTube to advertise their product or service from their YouTube gains income. Now, how company invested para lang i-advertise ang ilang product or services. So, we have platforms. Ano ang platforms? Kung sa diin kita nag-collaborate. Ano-ano na sila mga collaboration platform? We have YouTube. Okay? We have Facebook, Google Meet and everything. Mga platforms kung sa diin kita nag-connect. The more traffic, the more visitors ang ara may ara ang platform, the more potential customers you can get. Now, in terms of advertisement, okay? So as an IT, we have a field where we can create a advertisement. Kabalo kita mag-edit sang picture. Kabalo kita mag-edit sang video. Okay? Mag-animate. Okay? Kaya siyempre, may ara kita sang animation nga track. Okay? So, ang kinahanglan na lang naton is concept. And the concept, okay, will come from the business. Ano ba lang mga concepts? Different kind of advertisements. Okay? Pero, technically, ato na. Advertisement. Karon, may nabalaan ka bala ang company or business nga kailan sang advertisement? Ubrahan mo na. Okay, it could be picture lang na or it could be a video. Okay? So diin ka mag-umpisa. Sa picture, sa video. Okay? Ano bala ang mga captions mo dira? Oh, nga kailan. Ano mga colors nga kailan mo, text or font nga kailan mo? Okay? Para maka-advertise ka. As you can see, in Pin My UI, there are well-known graphics. Diba? Basta UI, ano color? Okay? Basta UI, ano makita natin sa UI? Gani? Ano nga color ang UI? Kita lang UI sa ano nga color? Ha?
Yellow or green, sir?
Oh, green. Diba? So karon, when we create a what we call when we create a advertisement, dapat ibagay naton sa preference, company preference. Kung makita nyo dere, every time nga may ara i-post, dere o, nag-include yun ang mga necessary nga mga colors. Kita nyo niyo, ang dalom niyo, ang puter. So, may ara, isang dark blue and then green. Okay? Hindi ka na madula ang logo. Nan, learn how to create a poster. Okay? Nan, advertisement na na. Oh. Ah. Ah, kita nyo na. May mga templates na nga radio. Nan. Okay? Advertisement na na. Oh. Mawala ka na yung YouTube ba? Oh. Nan. Ano pa? Oh. Ah, ano pa? Mayari ka na yung isa pa di oh.
Super power ko. Mangarap.
Oh, lang taon to niya? Oh, lang taon to kung langit. Kung makita nyo niya. Bele. Lang taon to. Mabatihan yung audio. Ay, hindi. Langit daw. Ay, naka ano gali.
Ang superpower ko, mangarap. Kapag ako nangangarap, napapabilis ko ang... Kapag...
Ito na.
Ang superpower ko, mangarap. Kapag ako nangangarap, napapabilis ko ang panahon. Kapag ako nangangarap, lumalabas ang natatago kong lakas. Kapag ako nangangarap, nakakaya kong makita ang hinaharap. Pero ang pangarap, di tulad ng superpower na bigla lang natutupad. Kailangan ang pangarap ko ng gagabay at sasabay sa akin para siguradong di ako maiiwan at tuloy-tuloy na suporta anuman ang mangyari. Kaya sa bawat pangarap at patuloy na pagsisikap, kasama at kasabay ko ang FINMA Education. Nabaguhin ang aking kinabukasan. Sa pagtupad ng pangarap, kasama ko ang FINMA Education.
What have you noticed? What is the product presented in the advertisement? Okay? Education. Diba? So, those are examples of advertisement. Okay? So, sa inyo, ano ang product nyo? Diba? Umpisa pa lang sa aton yung mga discussion. Dapat ang inyong business mumpisa sa passion nyo. Okay, passion. Para later on, hindi nyo paguntatan. Kaya kung hindi nyo na passion, mapilitan ka na lang itigayon ng ubra mo. Because, hindi mo palangga ubra mo, hindi mo palangga ang business. Okay? So, kung may passion ka, palangga mo ubra mo, ang business mo, so you will sustain the business. Okay? So once nga may ara ka na sa product or service, ano naman niya ang model na gamiton mo? So with the prior knowledge on how to build a business, anong mga legal, mga ano ang mga considerations nga kailan mo i-consider before you build a business. So now, may ara ka na sa product or service. Okay, may model ka na and then so ano mga models naton? Okay? Product naton in IT. In IT, ano dapat pwede natin i-build nga business model. Okay, we have advertisement. Okay? So advertisement, we have a technical field or technical skills. Okay, para dira. technical skills, ano na ang advantage na para sa aton. Like kung for example ang business naton pareho sa luto, ang luto paano naton i-deliver na, okay, pag-iis ang aton nga technical skills. Kabalo kita mag-edit pictures, video, magbutang captions, and so on so forth, right? So tanawan nyo na lang ang mga sample of advertisement sa YouTube, dumudamo examples dra, okay, Jollibee, sa McDo, kung paano nila. Pero there are some advertisement nga wala gin tigayon, okay, butsiling yun unethical. Okay, dapat ang inyong mga karakter dira is hindi man, lalo na hindi bata, bla, no? I-consider nyo ang PJ, parental guidance, is PJ, kung ano, paginada ang mga iyaka, MTRCB. MTRCB is the agency or office that monitors the ethical practices. Okay? Kung paano gina-broadcast ang mga videos in mainstream media. Okay? Mainstream media. Pero kung sa mga YouTube naman niya, YouTube sa may ano, community standard, follow nyo ang community standard and also mga copyright claims in Singapore. So, amo na siya mga consideration niya dira. So, advertisement. So, dapat may prior knowledge ka dira. Sample juice. Juice ang imong ano, niya product. Oh, paano mo na i-deliver? Okay? So, concept na lang na kulang dira. Concept kung paano nyo i-deliver. Number 2, affiliate. The affiliate model uses links embedded in content instead of visual advertisement. Uses embedded links. Instead of visual advertisement. So, muna yung pakita ko ginasin nyo. That are easily identifiable. For example, if you run a movie review website, you could embed affiliate links to Amazon within your reviews that allows people to buy the movie you are reviewing. Amazon will pay you a small commission for every sale that you refer to them. So, butilingon, affiliate sa commission base, o mag itag mo na lang niya, no? Itag mo na lang. So, with also with advertisement na gapon. Kumbaga, ano ka, ang nakipagkasundo ka kay Amazon, yung ang product ni Amazon, if you run our review website, you could embed affiliate links to Amazon. Tapos, may platform na, tapos, save mo or ipa embed mo ang imong links, okay, for your movie that allow people to buy the movie you are reviewing. And so we have Amazon. Ask for coordination sa Amazon. Amazon, pwede ni ba lang ang akon nga video ni pwede ni attach embed sa imong platform na. So that's how affiliation works in business model. Pero may mga ginatawag kita nga commission, pila na blang commission nga pwede nyo nga i-share dira o may kita na. Okay? Because Amazon is one of the popular business naton. Hindi lang popular. Strong foundation ni, eh. Okay? It has strong foundation in business. Brokerage. Business connects buyers and sellers and help facilitate a transaction. Okay? Facilitate a transaction. Buyers and sellers. Okay? they charge a fee for each transaction to either the buyer or the seller, and sometimes both. You gain income from portion of the sales. Kumbaga, may debtor ka lang, may ginabaligya itong may ginabaligya nga tawag siya na nga asset. Ikaw ang broker. So kung itigayon mo, example, may dota, no? May nagkakayala ka nagabaligya sa dota. Okay? Dota. Tapos, ginpangitaan mo sang buyer. So kung gin ano mo sila, gintigayon mo nga mag-meet sila kag matigayon nga mabaligya sang seller ang iadota sa buyer. So may ara ka sang share dira, may share ka. Okay? Now, before pa magkadto sa seller, ang magbalbi sa seller. Ya, ari dota ko baligya ulo ni 500,000. Okay? Pero sa seller, imbaligyan mo 750,000. Okay? Imbaligyan mo 750,000. So karon, gimpaistorya mo sila. Okay? 750,000. Pero kinambalan mo ang buyer, ang seller, ay sir, gimbaligya ako ni gili sa seller 750,000. Kung mabaligya ko ni, mabaligya mo ni 750,000, 250,000 akon, imo 500, pero may commission ba ko dahil 500 mo? Amo na tabo. Pero sometimes, ang inubras ang iba nila, kung ginbaligya 500,000, tapos, ano, 500,000 to, no? Pagabot sa buyer, buyer, 750,000, pero ang nabalaan lang ng isang seller 500 lang. Okay? Wala sa kabalo gali nga ginbaligya mo 750,000 to 50 kiliya. So kung natigayon without knowing, ay ala, may 250,000 kang aginan siya, wala labot, may commission pa. Amo nang gikatabo sa mga ginatawag natin sa mga pagbaligya sa mga ari-arian. Okay? So broker ka, ikaw mediator, ikaw nagtigayon. So importante lang dira para sa broker is knowledge. Knowledge in legal and everything nga kailangan para nga matigayon ang pagbaligya. And then may mga ginatawag na contracts. Okay? May itigayon. May legal contracts na. So proceeded eh. Concierge or customization. Some businesses take existing products or services and add a custom element to the transaction that makes every sale unique for the given customer. For example, there are customization happening or at a larger scale with product like Nike's custom sneakers. So, pwede ka kapatindog sa isa ka business na mayara sa business model ng concierge or customization. So, ang purpose ni is for add a custom element. Okay? Custom element sa isa ka product or sa isa ka business. Product sa business. Okay? So, for the number 5, crowdsourcing. If you can bring together a large number of people to contribute content to your site business, then your crowdsourcing business models are most frequently paired with advertising models to generate revenue. But there are many other iterations of the model. A good example of this are Patreon users. So crowdsourcing, also we can also consider the what we call YouTube, okay, because users contribute contribute content sa YouTube. Okay, so YouTube is only a platform where users can upload content. Okay, so once nga magsikat or maging makakuha ka sang imong followers sa YouTube, and then kung magsikat na, pwede ka makakuha sang revenue, may kita diray. Okay, may kita sa YouTube. So kung damo ka visitors, the more revenue you will get in the platform. So crowdsourcing, this intermediation is when you sidestep everyone in the supply chain and sell directly. Sidestep everyone in the supply chain and sell directly. Wow. So kumbaga, ano ka? Ang nagretso ka sa bodega, directly to the customer. So ano gani nga ton sa ano? Magtatawag kita nga B2B, B2C, diba? And some of those example. So we have business to client, okay? Magbaligya ka diretso sa customer. Okay? So hindi nga business to business. So we have directly to customers, allowing you to potentially lower cost to your customers and have a direct relationship with as well. So an example of business to client or B2C, if you want to make and sell something in store, you typically work through a series of middlemen to get your product from the factory. So may factory gidya. So aling dito sa factory umabudiga to the store shell. Nan. So magano ka mag practice ka sang disintermediation, meaning lalo na kung sa mga marketplace ka, no, Facebook or sa mga Shopee, ang mga taga marketplace na actually nagabakal na sila sa Shopee. Did you agree? Nasa marketplace sa Facebook? Did you agree nga nasa marketplace ang Facebook nagabakal isang product sa Shopee, Lazada? Ba mga strategy nila? may idea ka mo? Libre ko?
Balit do buy and sell, sir.
Oh, so buy and sell gani. Ang product nila halin sa may ano, sa may Shopee or sa Lazada. Pero paano sila makakita, dra, sandako? So may mga ara sa shopping direct bodega na mo. Kumbaga halin gid sa manufacturer. Pero may iban man da nga retailer lang. Oh, banyo nga idea da. Inakwa nila, for example, bi may kilala ka, gabalagya sa may marketplace, no? Constant gid na. Pero may ginakwaan na siya nga product. So monthly may ginakwaan na sila. Ano lang kita ang solusyon para dira dapat kabalo ka sang imong nga target market. Ang target market mo amo na siya makatag si mo assurance nga ang imong product ma-dispose na. For example, amo to gin example kubla, ang piyak balay mo naga maintenance ang amo na abulong. Okay, monthly na. So i-transaksyonon mo na nga, sir. Sakon ka lang kwa bulong manti sakon amo niya tagusi mo. So hindi may target market ka na, gin pangitaan mo na karon sa may Shopee. O kung sa diin man nga may factory dira, kung sa diin maka direct selling kaya sa imo ang customer, gin kwa mo ya sa may factory tapos gin diretso sa customer mo. So matabo dira, ang ginapractice mo is disintermediation. So ang isa pa kinada is ang nasa Shopee, Lazada, ginakuha nila ang ano, ang ginapangitaan nila ang mga free shipping. May mga free shipping mo, cash on delivery. So kay kung may kung ano, kay kung lain-lain ang store, lain-lain malang free shipping. Sa Bajilingon, ang iladara nga ginobra, ipangita sila sa mga store nga may mga free shipping in a specific or particular product. Tapos ang product nila na may ara na sa destination na after delivery. Because ang pinaka main solution malandara, you need to know your target market. Kaya kung kabalo ka sa target market mo, once ara ng product si mo, madispose mo da yun. Unlike akong ano, nga mabakal ka sa product sa Shopee, tapos mo pala nagbaligya mo, mangita ka pa sang market mo ay disposan sina, medyo mabudlay, paano madugayan ka pa na? Okay? That's why, may tawag kita sa mga previous natin yung module, nga anong namin nga i-practice? Okay? Anong mga namin nga i-practice dito? Okay? Ano mauna? Ang business o ang imong ano? Market. So dapat mauna ano yung market, dapat may ano ka na makita mo potential sa market mo. Okay? So and the rest will follow. Okay? So muna na importante. So Dell is a good example of this, where you can directly buy parts of the desktop computers from them to be used by you. Okay? So pwede ka makabakal direct sila ni. Pero may mga ibang pagid nga mga store ni nga pwede ka makabakal sang Dell. Oh, di ba? For example, pwede ka makabakal Dell product sa may Octagon. Pwede ka makabakal sa may Concept. Inso Inso 4. Okay. Laser Tech na pwede na. Pero directly pwede ka na kabakal sa Dell. Okay? Ang ano dira, ang disadvantage dira, kaya kung magkadto ka sa mga retailer, may saka pa na. Lalo na kung sa mga mall, mall price, ang mall price has big difference kung mag-direct ka sa may factory. Okay? Sometimes, kapatak man na 50% ang saka. Okay? Sa factory, amo lang ng bilya, for example, be mabakal mo lang ni sa factory 50, pero sa pag mall size mo, mo mall cost naga 100 peso na. So dako na ang saka basta sa mall size. Okay? Pero sa mga kilid-kilid, even though nga kung ano, makasigurado ka nga hindi piki. Hindi piki. Kaya sa mga mall na makasigurado ka nga naka-undergo na sa checking eh. Mga hindi bla pike. Basta mambal ka Nike ya. Nike na. Pero kung sa mga kilid-kilid, hindi sa mall, mambal ka bikaroon, oh Nike na, Nike na. Pero pike, gali. No? Mambal naman niya, Dickies na. Kado ka sa Dickies nga store, sa may mall, sa Robinson, makasigurado ka nga Dickies na. Pero kung sa mga kilid-kilid, dira, sa mga downtown, mambal Dickies na. Ay gali hindi Dickies, pike, gali nga Dickies. So mula ng ano mo disadvantage mo. Now, diretso kaya sa ano sa factory gid para nga maka lower price ka. Ha. So, amo na sang bintaha. So for the fractionalization, instead of selling an entire product, you can sell just part of the of that product with fractionalization business model. A good example of this is Disney Vacation Club, where they sell just part of one of their vacation home for limited time for every years for 4 weeks every years. So fractionalization. So and again, pwede natin may example ni makita nyo na mga Microsoft products, may mga applications nga limited lang ang gamit Microsoft. Okay? Or ang Zoom. Okay? Ang Zoom nga application. So may mga pre-trial na. Okay, pre-trial limited in Singapore. So ginagaan sang privilege ang user to use a product in a limited time. In a limited time, then also for limited time and then limited features. kung gusto mo makakuha sang ano, sang full features na, okay? Full services and unlimited or lifetime use of the product or application, so you need to buy it in full, okay? Pero may tinatawag kita nga fractionalization. Okay? So that's why may tinatawag kita nga free trial, pro, na may mga pro eh. Tapos may mga ano pa kinalagyan sa tinatawag nga mga paagi, mga type of fractionalization or model, business model. Okay? So hindi mo paghatag tanan. Para siya lang. Kumbaga kung sa relasyon pa, kung baye ka, hindi mo pagkatagtanan. Bilin-bilin ka man sa kugalingon mo para hindi ka pagbiyaan. Ay kung niyatag mo tanan, okay, biyaan ka, wala ka na bilin, kundi ang ibang ka suicide. Gimbiyaan ako, abis ang migo ko. Imbiyaan ka. Kung ginatag mo kitanan, wala ka na gimiging bilin, wala mo naging palangga o galingon mo. So, palanggao naman ko gulingon mo. Okay? Kahit kung maging dependent ka lang, matabo si mo, madula ng tao, madula na siya si mo. Diba? Kahit ang tao, gaka, ano eh, gaka dula man mo, diba? Kumagabot ang kung kwaon na sa ni God. Diba? And sometimes, kwaon sa sang iba niya, tao, biyaan ka. So, hindi pag partial lang. So, bilhin ka man sa kugalingon mo. Sa business, balik kita sa business. Okay? Strategy na siya. Business strategy. Pangitaan tayo ng example. Microsoft Office. Why could statistics? Okay, sige na lang. Pero makita nyo na sa mga pre-trial, sa pre-trial then sa sa pro, may makita nyo na mga features na ka-enable kung naka-pro ka. Naka-pro ka by dan mo bilog, kung mga pre-trial lang or limited lang. So limited lang features. So that's why may ginatawag kita nga business model nga fractionalization. So for the franchise, again, kita nyo sa mga 7-Eleven, mga ano na, mga Jollibee, may mga franchise na, may mga branches all over the world. And even subong isa, sikat isang tuktok. So, kung gusto mo magka-franchise, may baydan ka lang amount, and then pwede ka naka-operate. Okay? So, pero ang product na, siyempre, mahalin na yan sa main. Okay? Kung sa diin ng main office ng Jollibee, or kung ano man ang inyong ay i-operate. Franchising is common in the restaurant industry, but you also find it in all sorts of service industries, from cleaning businesses to staffing agencies. In a franchise business model, you are selling the recipe for starting and running successful business to someone else. So, if you are planning to have a franchise for Jollibee, you will get a staffing agencies. In franchise business model, you are selling the recipe for starting and running a successful business to someone else. So sa imo nga customer, so pwede mo ma-avail ang recipe na. Pero actually kung franchise ka, hindi na visible sa imo kay ang resibe, pero mabarigya mong product. Okay? Mabarigya mong product. May mayara ka lang da baydan for franchise cost or fee sa main sa Jollibee. Pero magamit mong product nila. Okay? So amo na siyang tawag nga franchise. So that's why makita nyo ang 7-Eleven na mura ang franchise. May mga ano na, may mga operators na. Unsin o may mga manager na nga nag-operate. So ginakuhaan nila franchise and then para makuha nila ang products ng 7-Eleven. So mag-bid sila dira sa 7-Eleven na bahala mag ma sang market sang infrastructure ano bagay na da ang mga products dira. All you need to do is to pay the franchise fee. Okay? So, amo na siyang tawag dira. Okay? Franchise. Premium. With the premium business model, you're giving away part of your product or service for free and charging for premium features. So, malapit-lapit sa fractionalization, no? Ang aton niya premium. Premium. No, premium, hindi sa premium. Premium isn't the same as a free trial where customers only to get access to a product or service for a limited period of time. Instead, the premium models allow for unlimited use of basic features for free and only charge customers who want to access to more advanced functionality. A very good example of this are recent mobile apps where you can gain an advantage if you spend real money. So leasing might seem similar to fractionalization, but they are actually very different. In fractionalization, you are selling perpetual access to part of something. Leasing on the other hand is like renting. Renting. So nagaparent ka, for example, you have a what we call a building. Okay, may building ka. Or Robinson. Kita nyo yung Robinson dira? Kita nyo may mga kiosk, may mga kiosk or mga area dira nga gina-occupy isang mga business. May mga kiosk bla, or sa ano ah, sa mga 1688. Kita nyo daw ang mga ano, may mga cart da, may mga ga-display. So kung plano mo magpatindog man da sang imong ano, sang imong business dira, magkuha sang ano, magkuha sang space dira. So that's what we call leasing. Leasing on the other hand is like renting. Na renting a space. At the end of a lease agreement, a customer needs to return the product that they were renting from you. A very good example of this are rent a car businesses. Nan. So leasing. Pakadto ka lang sa ano? Kadto ka lang sa leasing department sang Robinson. Gaysano. Nan. Kung sambol ang plano mo. Pero ang isa ang gin-example dire sa module isa nga to niya, car renting. Okay? So low touch. With a low touch business model, companies lower their prices by providing fewer services. The low touch business models means that customers need to either purchase additional services or do things themselves in order to keep costs down. A good example of this is IKEA, where you buy product furniture but you are the one who assembles it. You are the one who assembles it. Oh, diba? No, pasad lang, no? Low touch. Kadto ka sa may concept. Kadto ka sa concept. Kung gusto mo magbakal sa pasad o chop-chop ba lang apart, baklon mo lang ya sa ila ang product. Okay? Kaya kung ipasad nila, for example, may ginabaligya nga ano, complete set ng computer, mabakal mo siya. 30 mil. Okay, dala na da ang ano, mga tanan-tanan nga mga installed application, installation, setup, and everything. Okay? So, kung baklon mo sila 30 mil, sila ma-setup, sila ma-assemble, pero kung ikaw, gudya, ikaw ya, may idea ka na kung paano mag-assemble, mag-install, okay? Dagdagan pa sang ano, deduction sang application nga hindi dapat i-install, o Microsoft, kaya Microsoft, 5 mil na mo, 5 mil lang Microsoft Office, dadira sa 5 mil, and then Windows, han. So, okay, dagdag bagay na sa cost, so dako bayadan mo. Pero kung may ara ka na yung idea kung paano install na, so at least may buhin-buhin. Okay, so para magbuhin-buhin mo nga total cost. So, ikaw lang galing nga symbol. Okay? So, isa na siya. Pasad na togon. Marketplace. Allow sellers to list item the for sale and provide customers with easy tools for connecting to sellers. The marketplace business models can generate revenue from a variety of sources including fees to the buyer or the seller for successful transaction. Additional services for helping advertise sellers' products and insurance to so buyers have peace of mind. The marketplace model has been used for both products and services. The best example for this is our e-commerce website Lazada and Shopee. So balaan nyo naman ha. And also ang Yaka Facebook. Pay as you go instead of pre-purchasing a certain amount of something such as a cell phone, minutes, or loads. Customers get charged for actual usage of the end of the billing period. The pay as you go model is most common is in home utilities. A very good example of this is our water companies where we are billed for our usage of water. Pay as you go. Razor blade. The razor blade business model is named after the product that essentially invented that the model sell a durable product below cost to increase volume sales of high margin disposable component of that product. The add-on is continuously bought for profit. From the name itself, a very good example is shaving blade company such as a Gillette. Sino ka shave? Mas mahal yung Gillette. Reverse razor blade. Flipping the razor blade model around, you can offer a high margin product and promote sales of low margin companion product. The essential purchase is the big sale where the company makes most of its money. The add-ons are just there to keep customers using the initially expensive product. This is very common in Apple products where people buy newer iPhones and stays because of the apps. Oh. Because of the apps. So which is more better? The Android apps or the Apple apps? Siguro ang gusto ko lang gadya nga i-try si Siri. Kaya wala Siri sa Android eh. Tapos siling on, if I want to avail the Siri, I need to buy iPhones. Diba? So, amo na siya. Ang yung tawag nga, reverse razor blade. Na. So, example ba sa Windows, no? Sa Windows. If you wish to kung nanamian ka sa Microsoft Office kaysa sa may WPS or writer, okay, ano tawag siya na on sa Linux, no, Linux Office, ano lang yung tawag na Open Office. So Open Office, if you want to use Microsoft Office than Open Office. Ang Microsoft Office, iyan naka Microsoft. Okay? Iyan naka Windows. Ang Open Office, iyan naman naka ano? Iyan na siya ka Linux. So if you rather to use the Microsoft Office, so you need to install Microsoft Windows. No. So same with ano, this example. Okay? Gusto mo Siri? So you need to buy iPhone. So kumbaga may affiliation ng Japan. Reverse auction. A reverse auction business model turns auction upside down and has sellers present their lowest prices to buyers. Na, kung lalo na kung manag-expire, manag-expire ng product mo, i-auction mo na lang na para bakal iba na buy one take one. Kita nyo na ba buy one take one? Check nyo na yung ano? Check nyo ang expiration date kasi after 2 days expire na, no? Away ka balog, kasakit chan mo. Ay, may baka ko to auction, buy one take one. Ayun na, hindi mo na pagkaon, pero buy one take one. Ay, galay ah. Ba mo mga product, may mga expiration date na. Okay? So, the reason why nga ginabuy one take one because of the auction. Expired na. Manag-expire na. Nahan. So, ginapa-sale. Okay? Ginapa-sale or ginapa-auction. Okay, buy one take one and so on and so forth. So, ito strategy lang na. Buyers then have the option to choose the lowest price presented to them. You can see the reverse auction in auction when the contractor's bid could do work on a construction project. You also see reverse auction in a time you shop for mortgage or other type of loans. A good example of this is contractual house building. So to get more customer, okay? So, mga example lang na. Subscription. Subscription business models are becoming more and more common in this model. Consumers get charged a subscription fee, usually monthly or yearly, to get access to a service. While magazine and newspaper subscription have been around for a long time, the model has now spread to software and online service and is even showing up in service industries. A good example of this are Netflix, YouTube, and Google services. Diba? So, YouTube also has premium, okay, subscription, Netflix, and Google services. Access, and Cisco. May mga tawag man ang subscription na. So, pero may limited time expiration na. Diba? Grabing market nila, no? Hindi mo lang baklon one time. Hindi mo siya pagbaklon one time, may subscription pa. So may one year expiration strategy na sa mga business sectors, no? Grabe sila mga business. May renewal naan. So similar to brokerage, but instead of simply connecting buyers and sellers, you're connecting in helping create an excess supply of a service with buyers. A very good example, a Grab taxi and Airbnb. Araw. So ang brokerage, okay, ginatigayon mo nga mabakal mag successful ang transaction sa buyer and seller in access to excess, but instead of simply connecting buyers and sellers, you're connecting and helping create an excess supply of a service. So nagatagas ang ano, existing what they call service nga maging ano, maging service, additional service nga kailan ibaydan. So that's what they call access to excess. So from the list above, there are a lot of options for us IT on what is our business model. We can make up that are premium, subscription, and most common advertisement. And a later module, We will be discussing how companies, small, big, or even YouTubers exactly gain income from advertisements. So that's what we call in Google AdSense. Google AdSense is the key for income sa mga YouTubers. Because Google AdSense has many more companies registered. Wait lang. Para mag-idea. First is one. Google AdSense considerin din nakakita kwarta ang mga advertisement sa YouTube and iban nga mga vlogger. Mga website. Kita nyo na mga website, mga ano, asa mga Google apps may mga advertisement.
Informing.
Pero sa may Facebook, may tawag kita nga Facebook Ads. Facebook Ads. Okay, equivalent sang Google AdSense.
Advising, storytelling. Creating content your audience loves takes time. Making it profitable shouldn't. That's where Google AdSense comes in. With AdSense, trusted advertisers show their ads on your site, creating revenue for you from the content you make. That's revenue for you to keep creating great content and take your business to the next.
Revenue, the more traffic you will get, the more income you will get also. So, start building your platform, your credentials, or public figure online. Then you will get the followers. After the followers, you will get more traffic on your site or channel. Kung dako ang viewers mo, dako man ang revenue mo, dako man ang kwarta mo. Okay? So that's how the pirato gani ang ano mo, ang sige, kalunta lang ang discuss. Ito po sandali lang.
Level. With access to the world's largest advertiser base, AdSense is widely used. More than 2 million publishers, just like you, are using it. And because all ads are checked and powered by Google, you can be sure they're both appropriate and highly relevant to your audience. AdSense is easy, and getting started is fast. You just need your name, address, and Google account. Plus, it only takes one snippet of code to connect your site and start running ads. Yep, right there. Great, you're up and running. And that snippet, it does a lot. It gets you the best of Google's automation, automatically building the best setup for you. It lets you optimize your ads through smart technologies that get better over time. And most importantly, it gets you the revenue you need to create more amazing content, keeping more users happy, coming back, and growing your business over and over. You get the picture.
Okay, skill building activities with answer key number 1. Users, consumers, customers are charged a certain period of time to gain access to the service. What is that? What's the answer? May iba nagabanyagan na? Oh. Certain period of time, that is subscription. Number 2, the consumer is allowed to use the product for free. For free? from the term free, but if they wish to have full access to the system, they need to pay. They need to pay. What do you call that one? It is a premium. Freemium. Ababaw. Ayan. Yun ang premium. Damo niyo. Premium. Okay. Proceed. So, the add-ons to the product are continuously paid to make use of the full product. The add-ons to the product are continuously paid to make use of the full product. It is a laser or razor blade. Razor blade. So again, razor blade is named after the product that essentially invented that model. The model sell a durable product below cost to increase the volume sales of higher margin. Disposable component of that product add-on is continuously bought for profit from the name itself. A very good example is shaving blade company such as Gillette. Kita nyo na ang ano, ang Gillette spelling. Nan. Aryo. Adjustable na siya mo. So pwede mo na yung mga kakas-kakaso. Yakas, Aryo, mabakal mo doon ang ya blade. So ang handle ya, hindi ka na magbakal. Pero ang ya yung blade, pwede mo na baklon. Aling blade nyo? Nan. So alright. So I do recommend Gillette namin siya sa mga lalaki da. Nan. So number 4, providing information given from another business company to promote. Ano na sa? Providing information to promote their product. So it is advertisement. 5. You simply help a business in selling a product and you go gain portion of the sale. Wow. So that is brokerage. Ngita ka sang duta da nga ginabaligya. Na. Tapos itigayon mo sila nga duwa. May porsyento kagalagaling i-set mo lang sa may seller. Essay. Question. Compare and contrast leasing and fractionalization. Okay? Ano na siya?
One, fractionalization lets the user use the product for every set period of time, such as a part of a resort in a specified months in a year. In other words, for those months you own that part of a resort. As for leasing, you are borrowing a product or object such as a car, paying it in the amount of time used and returning it in the end. 2. In a way, yes, because you are selling a toy that still needs to be assembled to make it the actual toy that it is supposed to be. It can also be a no, because assembling the toy is considered to be the most fun part of the product. Two, can toys that needs assembly be considered a low-touch business model? Explain. 2. In a way, yes, because you are selling a toy that still needs to be assembled to make it the actual toy that it is supposed to be. It can also be a no, because assembling the toy is considered to be the most fun part of the product.
Can toys that need assembly for considered be considered as low-touch business model? In a way, yes, because you are selling a toy that still needs to be assembled to make it the actual toy that is supposed to be. It can also be a no, because assembling the toy is considered to be the most fun part of the product. So, for the what I know, please answer what I learned, what you have learned on this module. Then for the activity 4, project update. So you need to have a, what we call simple, generated ideas. Okay, generated ideas. Again, ideas is not a what we call hindi pa na siya potential nga namambal nga ano, feasible, no? So para maging feasible sa, so dapat maganda ka na isang ano, mga brainstorming na mga necessary details na kailangan lang yung i-consider. So identify what business models you will use for your project, enumerate them, and explain why you choose this business model, and explain the process on how to does the business model can provide your business profit. Do take note that you can use more than one business model. So pwedeng more than one. Advertising the app for monitoring and managing employee performance as banner ads while working, and it has video ads. After compiling and generating a daily, weekly, monthly reports, freemium. Okay, the users can buy the app to remove the ads and use an ad-free version for the of the system. Plus, it opens a few features such as exporting the reports as an Excel rather than PDF file. So that's the end of our module. So I hope you learned for this module number 7. So we are lack of number 8 pa. Maybe we'll be sending to you the